Hey everybody, Dr. Dan here, and this is module 5. So this is going to be a fun module. Again, since we're considering this question, whether healthcare is a right or a privilege, you have to make some decisions. So I want you to kind of go with your gut in this module and start thinking about what your position is on the question of right or privilege. So if you think healthcare is a right, that means that it needs to be provided to everyone. And if it needs to be provided to everyone, there needs to be a way to pay for that. So in most cases, it's always been taxes. That's what funds the government. If you can think of some miraculous new way to fund a program as big as universal healthcare, that's great. But in most cases, it's going to come back to taxes. So that's one thing you need to think about. If you think healthcare is a privilege, then you basically are saying we don't need universal health care. The system we have now is fine, even though there are, you know, millions of people that aren't covered. It works, so, or it doesn't work. So start to think about your opinion. There's no right or wrong answer here. The entire country is basically split on some of these questions. And what I thought I would do for this module is I want you to go out and look at a website. I put a link in this module for you to do so, and it's going to talk about what arguments were in place when Social Security passed in the 1930s, and then in the 1960s when Medicare and Medicaid came down the line. There have been these arguments against these programs the whole time, and I hate to be one-sided with this, but I think we can be in this case, because even though Social Security was extremely controversial and really passed by a close margin back in the 1930s, at this point it's something that we're all used to in society. And there are some outliers who still are against Social Security, maybe want to fund Social Security differently, but it's an accepted part of U.S. society right now. And I would argue that's the same thing with Medicare and Medicaid. If the government tried to take those programs away, it would be catastrophic to society, and the majority of the people in the country wouldn't be happy about it. So, you know, one of the bigger points is that many of these programs have been controversial at their beginning, but once they're in place and people get used to them, they become accepted as the norm. So think about that, and think about that in the context of universal health care. So whether we're talking specifically about the ACA, the Affordable Care Act, or some other universal health care program that you can think of, start to think about this idea, because it's obvious that the ACA has been controversial since it was signed into law in 2010, and it's still controversial right now. So give it some thought. The survey assignment is a 5-minute timed assignment. I'm asking you to write one sentence on each position. I want you to take a position for universal health care. That is saying basically that health care is a right, and I want you to take a position against universal health care, which in that case you're saying health care is a privilege. And I want you to formulate an argument either way, just a really quick, whatever your gut is. You have 5 minutes to do two sentences on the survey, so don't worry too much about prose or grammar or composition, but I want you to give me two complete sentences. And this is not a locked-in opinion by any means. What we're going to do in the next module is we're going to look at a broader collection of opinions for and against healthcare, universal healthcare. And then as we move into module 7 and 8, you're going to start a persuasive project, and that's where you'll sort of lock down what your position is at this point. But I think it's important that you're able to take a position for what you believe in, and also to take a position against what you believe in. That's building critical thinking skills, and it's allowing you to step into the shoes of someone who may argue with you over what you feel, and it's important. So that's it for this module. Have fun with it. Don't stress out too much over the timed survey. Just do the best you can. Take care. Bye-bye.